Oh, I'm really sorry. I did not notice you looking at me. I know. I'm sexy. As you can see, the mood in the room has changed a little bit. I'm sure you've noticed the candles in the background. Don't worry. Valentine's was just on Thursday. So, you're here to watch tech advice regarding laptops. Why am I choosing to review laptops today? See, I noticed the other video, the laptop one, the mid-priced laptop video, was quite popular. 1,000 views, making it the highest viewed video on my channel. So today I had to spice it up to make sure that you enjoy my videos, to make sure that you're in the sexy mood because we're in Valentine's mood. We're still in February, so Valentine's carries on for like 2 weeks, you know. At least for me. Anyway, you're here to watch a review on LENOVO laptops that you can buy that are suitable for content creators and gamers. I just want to get a little taste, put it right on my plate and serve it up, girl. Your loving is the best, it's working up an appetite, and baby. This video is brought to you courtesy of TechBuys. Get all your personal computing needs sorted out. And if that doesn't convince you, these guys also ship from Amazon. Check them out in the link in the description below. So I'm going to start these videos in a chronological order from the cheapest one up to the most expensive one. So up on the screen, we have the LENOVO IdeaPad 130. As you can see, it's a plastic finish on the top. Now, LENOVO has never been known to be high, I mean, to have the best designs. At least that's in my case, for I mean, that's in my observations. Like, I've never found a laptop, or I've never found their laptops as appealing to look at. So I was trying to wait there. It's on average, I mean, in terms of weight. As you can see, it has a grill at the bottom, which is necessary because it's rocking a graphics card. So the cooling is necessary. And there's nothing out of the ordinary for this one. Okay, on the inside there, okay, this one was new. It was not on the display. I think it's a brushed aluminum. I don't know if that is metal on the top, because it feels like metal because it was kind of cold. And as you can see, this one is rocking a Core i5 6006U processor, clocked at 2 gigahertz. Also, it has a 1 terabyte hard drive and 4 gigabytes of RAM, and a display that is 15.6, which is HD. I mean, it's 1366 × 768. It's rocking a 2 GB graphics card from Nvidia, an MX110. Yeah, I mean, those are the nitty-gritty details that you're supposed to be worried about, the graphics card and the processor. And this one retails for 40,000 Kenyan shillings. As you can see, it has decent IO, a full-sized disc reader, and I don't know what that small hole was for. On the other side, as you can see, we have a full-size SD card reader, headphone jack, 2 super speed USB ports, and an HDMI and an Ethernet and a power adapter. So no USB type C for this one. So it's not kind of a big deal, because I mean, people are still adopting USB type C. Overall, this is the best value for your money at this price range. Okay, so up next on the screen, we have the LENOVO IdeaPad 330. This one retails at 50,000 Kenyan shillings. Obviously, it's high in price because it has some few things different. So basically, the basic, or let's just say same finish as the previous laptop there. So this laptop was not heavy, was not light, so it's averagely weighted there. As you can see on the rear bottom, we have air inlets and air outlets there, so cooling is not going to be so much of an issue there. So on when we flip this laptop on the other side, as you can see, we have a DVD / CD reader. Still surprised that these things are still on these laptops. On the other side there, when we flip, as you can see, we have an additional port, which is a USB type C, a full-size SD card reader, 2 super speed USB ports, HDMI and Ethernet, and power inlet. So the one thing that I will say is, if you plan on buying these machines, 4 gigabytes of RAM is not going to cut it. You can buy it right now, and again later on you can upgrade, or just make sure you understand or know which type of RAM your laptop is using, and just go to town and request for an additional 4 gigabytes of RAM. So I recommend 8 gigabytes of RAM. So as you can see on the inside there, basically the same finish, and the weird placement of the power button there. I don't know why Lenovo places their power buttons there, so because it usually confuses me sometimes. So this one is rocking a Core i5-H250U processor clocked at 1.6 gigahertz. As you can see, it also has an NVIDIA MX series graphics card with a 2GB video memory, 1TB of hard drive space, 4GB of RAM. I think I'd already said that, and 15.6 Full HD TN display there. So the keyboard is not as clicky as the one you plug into your desktop. Again, the mouse pad still average. So again, this is an average laptop just for the average user. But in this case, I recommend this for content creators and gamers. It's the best value for your money. So up next on the screen, again, we still have a Lenovo IdeaPad 130. Okay, this one retails for 68,000 Kenya shillings. Now, in a few minutes, you're going to understand why it retails for that price. But this one, again, averagely weighted, not too heavy, not too thin, I mean not too light. So air intake ventilation there at the bottom, so cooling again is always a priority if you want your laptop to perform. So the design is basically the same, which is kind of monotonous and boring, so I'd prefer that there was a little bit of variety. So on the side there, we have again a DVD/CD reader, which again is kind of unusual because I mean very few people, I mean the people that I know, let me just say the people that I know don't use DVDs anymore or CDs. So as you can see on the other side, surprisingly enough, this one doesn't have USB type C, but it does have a full-size USB, full-sized super speed USB ports, SD card reader, power inlet, Ethernet, and a full-size SD card reader. So if we go to the inside there, you're going to notice that it's a little bit different. In this case, this one, for some reason, the Core i7 seems to degrade in terms of the finishing, like it's too much plastic. Like I was trying to feel it there and I was wondering why it's too much plastic. Again, the keyboard not as clicky as the one you plug into your desktop. Again, the weird power button placement there at the corner, which I keep on mistaking for a button, because Lenovo, why couldn't you just place that button somewhere else? So this one is rocking a Core i7-8550U processor clocked at 1.8 gigahertz, an NVIDIA 2GB MX graphics card. Now this one has 8 gigabytes of RAM, so this one is the one that I would recommend the best. So 15.6 Full HD display, and so this one retails for 68,000 Kenya shillings. So there's nothing much going on about this laptop. So up next on the screen, we have the mother of all laptops here. This is indeed a workstation laptop. As you can see, this one looks very heavy in design, and that's because Legion is Lenovo's line of gaming laptop. So premium finish on the outside there, like the placement of the logo, very nice logo. And this one is heavy. If you plan on buying this one is indeed heavy. As you can see also on the bottom there, very very big air inlets, because this is a machine, this is a beast there. Okay, I think it's heavy because of the battery. So as you can see on the IO there, we have a mini display port, USB type C, USB type A, Ethernet, HDMI, that's the power inlet there. And if you flip it over, let's just say in this case I did not flip it over. I think I was too excited for this laptop because man, this laptop was just nice to hold. As you can see, we also have an additional USB, which is a super speed, because I can see the super speed logo there. Also on the other side, we still have the USB type A and a full-size headphone jack. You can see some breathing room at the back there, so this is definitely a workstation. Okay, so even before we continue, this one retails from 100,000 and above. Now I did not specifically inquire about the brand of this one, because the Legion line is, we have like the Y's something, the Y's that, the Y230. You can see massive power brick, 170 watt. Everything about this laptop is just heavy, but it's necessary, because this thing is a beast. Trust me, this thing will do heavy gaming, this thing will do heavy graphics work. I mean, this is the type of laptop you buy if you have the money to spend and you are a mobile person, you keep on moving. Okay, on the inside there, again, premium finishing, this time good placement of the power button, clicky keyboard. Surprisingly enough, this one was a little bit clicky, but again, not, you're not going to get the satisfaction you get from a desktop keyboard. Core i7, this rocks a Core i7, a GTX graphics card. It specifically, this one had a GTX 1060, which is a very, very powerful graphics card. The touchpad there was mediocre, there's nothing special about it. And one thing that I did notice, I don't know what's with Lenovo and their weird placements. The webcam is at the bottom of the screen, but I am assuming that is to give the screen more room. And this one is a full HD display screen, 1080p, full HD. So I went ahead and ran some demo. So I connected my hard drive, and in this case, I plugged GTA 5. As you can see, even having without installed the NVIDIA graphics card drivers, the game was still running miraculously and well. So I think this one has 16 gigabytes of RAM, the current model that you're seeing on the screen there. And yeah, so if you're a little bit confused about what category you fall into, or you're not sure that you're a content creator. Now, content creator doesn't mean necessarily YouTuber. It means anyone who's generating content for either entertainment or for information purposes. So these are video editors, photographers, architects, just creating content from scratch. That is what I would say. So for gaming, all the other laptops that I have mentioned, you're going to be doing some light gaming on them. But obviously, if I was to recommend any laptop, this is the laptop that I would recommend, the Lenovo Legion, because this thing can do this job without even just feeling as if it's lagging behind because of the demand of these softwares. So hope you enjoyed this video. So let me get back to my face. So thank you for taking the time to watch that video. I really enjoyed making it. If you like more of this new me, or maybe you want to see this is what I'm gonna do. Anyway, let's get back to normal. If you want to see more of these videos, comment, like, you know, share it, whatever all other YouTubers say. And I mean, I'm Kenyan Elizabeth, and I'm joking, I'm telling you, yo, bro, this accent doesn't sound Kenyan now, because I'm Kenyan, bro. I'm Kenyan. Anyway, expect more, and sorry for being away, you know, January. And I'll see you in the next one. Don't forget to subscribe, by the way. I don't know why I did not say that. Did I say that? Anyway, see you in the next one.